Hello everyone, welcome to JOVITECH. I know it has been a long time since the last video, but today I have a very special video for you guys, something that most of my viewers wanted me to make. So in today's video, we would be building our very own 3D printer. If you know me, I love building stuff and doing DIY projects. So I was in the search for a tool that could help me prototype my ideas quickly. And here is where I stumbled upon this 3D printer technology. But sadly, buying a 3D printer costs quite a lot and somewhat unaffordable. So this is how I started my journey building a near replica of the 3D printer that I wanted. I know, it's crazy, right? So this is a detailed step-by-step video to help you make your own 3D printer. I will also show you the mistakes that I made and also share some valuable key points which will not only save your time and money but also make your 3D printer better. So without wasting much time, let's get started. Now let's prepare the y-axis. For this we need two M10 threaded rods which are about 380 mm in length. We also need four 3D printed y-axis corner parts along with M10 washers and nuts. Screw the nuts into the threaded rods as shown. Make sure that the distance between the y-axis corner and the washer after the counter nut to be 100 mm. For distance between the two y corners, use 350 mm smooth rod. Now using the two 8 mm threaded rods, screw the M8 nuts as shown, keeping the Y motor mount somewhere in the middle. The precise distance of this part is not necessary at this moment. Similarly, do the same thing and screw the Y idler part in the place. Again, the precise distance of this part does not matter. Notice that I use 3D printed idler. This is because I forgot to order the idler, the metal idler, and shipping would have taken some time. So I just printed one and to my surprise it worked flawlessly. Now insert the y-axis front and back part into the y-axis side elements as shown. Ensure correct placement and orientation of the parts. Note that Y motor mount is closer to the double nut. Secure these parts using M8 washers and nuts. You can use the smooth rods to align the parts as well. Try to make sure it is as rectangular as possible. If you want, you can even use the wooden frame to align and to make sure it's rectangular. Okay, let's make the Y carriage. Screw the Y belt holder using two M3 screws. Place the linear bearings as shown and secure them using zip ties. Again, ensure the correct orientation and please refer to this picture while making your printer. Time to mount the motors. First, temporarily face the stepper motor towards the frame and attach the y-axis distance holder as shown. Then secure the motor using 10 mm M3 screws. After this, mount the end stop, again using the same 10 mm screws. Insert the 8 mm smooth rods into the carriage and slowly mount it to the frame by applying pressure to all four corners. Make sure that the side having the single bearing is opposite to the motor. Move the carriage and ensure that the movement is smooth. Secure the rods using zip ties at all four corners. Now flip the whole assembly and using a plier, insert the belt in the belt holder. Loosen the y-axis motor screw and rotate the motor as shown. Then attach the pulley to the motor and loop the belt around the idler followed by the motor pulley and back to the belt holder. Then the tension of the belt should not be tight at this moment. Then rotate the motor back and adjust the tension in the belt. With this we complete our y-axis. Again make sure that the frame is rectangular and is leveled. If not,
If it's not leveled, loosen the M10 nuts and try to level it using a smooth surface, such as the floor.
Okay, let's start building the x-axis. Prepare the 3D printed parts. For this, we will need the motor mount and the idler mount. Insert the linear bearing into the printed parts as shown. Here I am using my magical powers, but you can press on a flat surface to easily fit the bearings. Place the second bearing in a way such that the inner balls of the second are rotated by around 45 degrees compared to the first. This will ensure a greater contact with the smooth rod. Now do the exact same thing for the X motor mount. Insert the N3 square nuts and screw the idler part using 10mm M3 screws. This will be used to tension the belt later. Make sure you do not over tighten them. For this step, we will need to use the 370mm smooth rods. These will be the longest rods. Then insert the rods with the bearings into the printed parts. Prepare the X carriage by inserting the zip ties as shown. Make sure they are inserted in the right direction. Then place the carriage on the X axis. Tighten the zip ties, making sure that the bearings are positioned properly and fit perfectly into the printed parts. Then mount the motor using 18mm screws such that the connector of the motor is facing downwards. Then insert the motor pulley. We'll adjust the exact position later. Then I screwed the end stop in place as shown. Now insert the timing belt all the way in the belt holder, making sure of the correct orientation. Tighten the belt using a plier. Finally, loop the belt through the idler pulley and then guide it through the X carriage followed by the motor pulley. At this moment, loose the motor screws and rotate the motor a bit. Then insert the other end of the belt to the belt holder. Make sure that it is neither very tight or very loose. Then trim the excess belt and fix the motor back in place. With this, we finish the X axis. Finally, let's assemble the Z axis, which is the easiest of all the axes. Begin by placing the Z-axis motor mount on the frame as shown. Pay close attention to these mounts as they are of two different types, left and right. Place the parts on the frame such that the small circular opening is closer to the frame's outer edge. This is the same mistake I made and had to redo the whole assembly. So please take care as it will save you a lot of time. Screw the stepper motor to the motor mount using 10mm screws as shown. For better wiring and cable management, I kept the motor connectors pointing inwards. Then attach the flexible coupler to the motor and the whole assembly should look something like this. Then insert the remaining two smooth rods into the circular holes, after which I attach the treaded rod to the flexible couplers. One more step before mounting the Z axis to the X axis. For this, use the M5 nuts and fix it in the Z axis nut holder. Make two such nut holders and screw them to the X axis motor and idler mount. Finally, align the Z axis and X axis and carefully and slowly try to slide the x-axis on the rods by rotating the treaded rods by using your hand. Then place the z-axis top and left mounts as shown, making sure the frame is aligned, and then flip the whole assembly. Secure the parts using M3 screws and nuts. Here I am using an Allen key and a plier to securely tighten the screws. With this, we finish the Z-axis. If you have reached so far, congrats! We are almost very near completing the hardware. So now, in this part, I will be joining the Y-axis to the frame. It's very simple. Just grab the Y-axis assembly in one hand and using your other hand to hold the frame, slowly slide down the Y-axis into the frame. Ensure that the frame is between the washers for better support. Then slowly tighten the M10 nuts using a spanner. With this, the final assembly should look something like this. Isn't it beautiful? Finally, let's work on the extruder. First of all, prepare the parts by mounting the square nuts in the appropriate positions as shown. Then place the hexagonal nuts in their respective places. To make my life easier, I used a long screw to help me align and push the nut into the groove. Even you guys can use the same trick. After placing the two nuts, one in the forward and one backward, slide the extruder body on the nozzle and make sure that it is a snug fit. Similarly, place the M3 nuts into the nut traps of the extruder cover, here and here as shown. Once this was done, I simply put the two parts together. On the right, I am using a 18mm screw, and on the left side, I am using a 30mm screw with a washer. Fix the plastic shaft into the 6 to 5 bearing, then mount it to the holder by pushing the bearing. Make sure that the bearing is smooth and is able to rotate freely. Fix the motor to the extruder using a 30mm screw. Gently tighten the motor screws and do not over tighten them as the plastic might crack. Similarly, mount the idler in place using the 30mm screw. Using a small piece of filament, try to align the pulley, after which you can tighten it using an Allen key. Prepare the extruder idler screws using a 40mm screw along with a washer and a spring combination as shown in this video. Then insert two square nuts in the slots and finally, using an Allen key, securely tighten the idler springs. Make sure you do not over tension the springs as that might cause difficulty putting in the filament. Moving on, mount the radial fan using two 20mm screws and also the inductive probe. We will adjust the height of the inductive probe later. A small note, I made sure to include the latest revision of the printed parts. In the latest revision, you can directly screw in the probe sensor, which makes it so easy while calibrating. Now place the screws at various positions on the X carriage as shown. Next, guide the extruder cables, then followed by positioning the extruder properly. Finally, secure it by tightening these three screws. You can also take some time and do some cable management at this moment. Also, do not forget to add the small side fan. Okay, so this completes the mechanical assembly, and now we can move on and do the electronics in the next part. Okay, so let's assemble the electronics. For this, I found that using an Arduino board along with a RAM's 1.4 shield was the cheapest option and does the job. Apart from that, I am using a DRB8255 stepper driver. Another alternative to this would have been using an A4988 stepper driver. Then I mounted the frame to the Arduino using simple zip ties, and after inserting the RAM's 1.4 shield, it should look something like this. After which I mounted the power supply to the frame by drilling two holes. Here I have used a 12 volts 30 amps power supply, which is a bit overkill, and a normal 20 amps power supply should work just fine. Fix the heated bed to the Y carriage using 25mm screws. I am also using a M4 nut as a spacer. Note to use at least 14 AWG and above wires for the heated bed, as this does require some serious current. Speaking of high current requirement, the MOSFET on the RAM's board was just not powerful enough to supply and would just burn off. I had this issue for both of my 3D printers. To solve this, I would highly recommend using MOSFET boards such as this one, as this can deliver a ton of power and decrease the heating time. Another alternative is to make your own MOSFET board using an MOSFET such as IRF3708. Connect the wires to the RAM's board as shown in the schematic. The wiring gets a bit messy and hence it is very difficult to show on video. After the connections are made, just double check the power cables and the stepper driver orientation. In this video, we finished the complete hardware assembly. In the next part, we would be installing the software and also doing the necessary calibration to get decent print quality. Until then, please like, share and subscribe, and see you in the next one.